Oh my God.
What?
There was another mass shooting.
Well, which one? There was like four today.
It says it was at a Chuck E. Cheese's.
I know about that one. I'm reading about the one at the nursing home.
Wait, which nursing home? Was it the one for the elderly people or the one for the defenseless puppies?
Defenseless puppies.
Well, shit. Now I don't know who to send my thoughts and prayers to.
Well, what I've been doing, and this has been working great for me, is I have a template now that I use for every time there's a mass shooting.
How does that go?
It's basically something like, my thoughts and prayers go out to the blank, and I am blank and blank. And then those last two words, I usually put either like something like horrified or disgusted.
Ooh, petrified.
Oh, I like that. I don't think anyone has used that one yet.
Yeah, and then I end it with, you know, something about gun violence or gun laws. And it just, it's so great because it takes the stress off an already stressful moment.
Right, right.
You know what I mean? And like, now I don't have to worry about it. I have it in my drafts and it's saved and then...
Can you send me a copy of that?
Yes, I can.
Thank you.
Me too.
You got it.
Word.
Oh, shit! Oh!
What?
Oh my God, dude. Another sexual assault case.
Oh my God, who was it this time? Let me guess, Rob Schneider or Dick Cheney?
No, you're not gonna believe this.
Who?
You're not gonna believe this shit. What? Or maybe you will.
What?
Santa Claus.
I believe it.
Yeah, right?
Dude's a creep.
He was a creep. Kind of weird, like all the time with the beard and stuff.
The kids?
Yeah, and the kids. You kind of saw it, right?
I did.
Apparently, this motherfucker, he's been fingering reindeer and fucking elves. Gross.
So does this mean that Christmas is over?
It seems like it, Marlon. I mean, now if you celebrate Christmas, you basically support rape.
Man, I miss the good old days when celebrating Christmas meant you supported capitalism.
Oh, shit. I guess Antarctica is now completely melted.
Oh yeah, because of climate change.
Oh yeah, and I guess all the polar bears and penguins have gone extinct.
Marlon, for a second there, I thought you were gonna say something shocking.
No. Whoa, 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 chill.
Sorry.
There was just another mass shooting.
Oh, what? Wow.
Really consider it. I wasn't even done with my tweet about the last one.
Oh man, you're backed up now.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna take off.
Hey, where are you going? Out into the world?
Yeah, I was just gonna go get fresh air.
We're in the backyard, Brandon. We've got plenty of fresh air right here.
Well, I mean, you guys are, if I'm being completely honest, you guys are just bumming me out, so I think I'm gonna.
Don't get shot by a crazy man.
Yeah, keep your head up so you can see the nukes coming from North Korea.
And don't breathe in all the smog that's now been scientifically proven to cause cancer.
Okay, guys, well, always a treat seeing you. So, see you later.
Yeah, have fun, bud.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
What?
Oh, no, I was just practicing saying that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You know you shouldn't smoke in public.
What?
You shouldn't smoke in public. It's not good for other people.
Okay, well, how about other people just mind their own business, huh?
And how about you don't treat the world like it's your backyard?
Says the person telling somebody what they can and can't do.
You're an asshole.
Sure.
Hey, where are you? I already made the popcorn.
Sorry, I just got held up at Jason's place.
It's all right. Just get here quick, okay?
Have you picked out something yet?
Yeah, so I was thinking either The Room or Casablanca.
Casablanca? That's like one of the best movies ever made. I thought we had bad movie nights on Thursdays.
Yeah, and it's a bad movie. It's all like black and white, and everyone talks like, yeah, see, we gotta solve the case, yeah.
Okay, you totally haven't seen the movie.
No, I have not. But can you just get over here? I just made this whole bowl of popcorn, and I do not need you to eat the whole thing.
Okay, I'm gonna get in my car now.
Okay, love you.
Love you too. Bye.
Hey, you shouldn't smoke, you know, it'll kill you.
Jesus Christ, okay, can everyone please just mind their own fucking...
Hey, can you hear me?
Who's there?
Now that's the million-dollar question, ain't it?
Where am I?
How do you feel?
I'd feel a lot better if I knew where I was and who I was talking to.
You are nowhere, and you're talking to no one.
That doesn't answer my goddamn question.
Well, maybe if you stopped using my name in vain, I might answer some of your questions, you little shit.
Wait, you're God?
Sure.
Holy shit.
Okay, you know, if you could use any other expletive, literally anything else.
Wait, does that mean that I'm dead?
I wouldn't say that.
What would you say?
Not living.
So dead.
Well, you can be these things and still have a pulse, so let's just say lack of consciousness.
I don't understand why you're being so vague about this. Are you even really God?
Of course I am.
Then prove it.
Okay, what do you want to know?
Okay, why is everything so shitty now?
What do you mean?
You know what I mean. Like, why is there an act of extreme violence committed every half second? Like, why is everyone angry at each other all the time? Why has nature gone to shit?
Wait. What are you talking about, nature?
Nature, like bunnies and trees and shit.
Fuckhead, you're a part of nature. You're an animal. And everything you just described is part of nature as well.
Wait, so cars and buildings are a part of nature? That's insane.
Were they made by humans?
Yeah.
And did they make those things using elements of the environment, like metal and wood?
Yeah, but when we make buildings and roads, it destroys forests and the ozone.
So, how is that any different than a bunny digging a hole or a bird making a nest?
Because that's just what those animals have to do to survive. Wait, so you're saying that us mass slaughtering cows and like destroying forests, that's just part of nature? That's bullshit. We're destroying the environment.
You're part of the environment, dude. And are you really going tit for tat on this with me, of all people?
Well, I've just been taught, you know, to care about the environment, about trees and bunnies and shit, you know, to be an activist.
Oh my me. What makes you think that you know what's best for a bunny or a lion? Or even trees, for Christ's sake. You want to know the truth? Most animals don't give a fuck about other animals. A bunny doesn't give a shit if a deer gets killed. There are no bunny activists. It's just trying to protect itself and its species from its environment and other predators at best. The only thing that separates bunnies from humans is ego.
Okay, what about my dog and cat? You know, they love me. That's cross-species love, man.
No. It's Stockholm Syndrome. You've abducted an animal and you forced it to live with you by withholding its food and water. Everyone with a pet is pretty much just a pervert to keep someone in their basement. It's just the species is different.
Okay, fine. What about war and violence? You know, every time you blink, there's an act of terrorism.
Trust me, I know. We had to change the thoughts and prayer pile into a mountain recently.
And do you answer those?
Dude, I'm in charge of literally millions of different galaxies and universes, with trillions of different species all dealing with their own individual shit. You guys act like that one needy sibling who needs all the attention.
So what, you do nothing?
Not at all. I send down people all the time who are supposed to spread peace and love. Gandhi, Martin Luther King Jr., JFK, John Lennon, Abe Lincoln, to name just a few. What, haven't they figured it out yet?
Oh, about that.
What?
We killed them.
Are you serious? All of them?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
What?
Hey, did you know that all those peace spreaders we sent down to Earth got murdered?
Yeah, we all play Yahtzee every Thursday.
Those are the guys you play Yahtzee with?
Yeah, and Pictionary.
Wait, then why don't you just send them back down to Earth in like a different form or something? Don't you have the power to do that?
That's true, Jesus, we do.
Yeah, but none of them really want to go back down to Earth, Dad. They say it, I don't know, it just sucks down there.
Oh, yeah, I mean, it does.
You can thank me for that.
Oh, shut up, Satan. You're always trying to take credit for everything.
That's because I am the reason.
You're not the reason that humans are the way they are. Stop lying.
Well, no, but I did invent social media, and that's not making them any better.
Wait, what? Satan invented social media?
Well, yeah. It makes everybody commit the seven deadly sins, dummy.
What are you talking about?
Think about it. It lets you all yell at each other with wrath without backing down because of pride.
And it makes you envy other people having a good time and the amount of likes they get, which makes you greedy for your own.
And it lets you lust after each other through DMs and dating apps. You know, all those nudes you all love sending.
And usually you do this all while lying around and eating a lot of food you don't need, which is...
gluttony and sloth.
Now you're starting to get it.
And so far, it's been making people worse and worse towards each other. I barely even have to do anything anymore.
Okay, wait. So, if we're part of the environment, and we're destined to destroy the Earth and ourselves, then what's the meaning of life?
Again with that question? I swear, you guys ask me that question so much, I'm considering putting it next to the Thoughts and Prayer Mountain. Okay. What do you like doing? For fun, I mean.
Watching movies with my girlfriend.
Emma?
Yeah.
You love her?
Yeah, of course I love her.
Okay. Well, just keep doing that.
Wait, that's it? That's it? Just relationships? That's the meaning of life? That's crazy.
What else is there? You remember those people you yelled at right before you wound up here?
Yeah, the people that were judging me for smoking.
And the people you judged for being judgmental?
What about them?
Did you ever stop to consider what they may have been through in their life to propel them to say what they said to you? Did you ever stop to think that maybe that woman lost her father to cancer just 2 days ago? Or that the guy across the street was the nurse who pronounced her father dead? And later found out it was because he smoked?
No, I just yelled at them because they had a different opinion than me.
There you go. You got angry and defensive instead of empathetic and loving. It's much easier to hate someone than to love them.
So that's the meaning of life then. Just love each other. That's like the biggest cliche there is.
You got any better ideas? Look, you want some meaning to life? Kiss someone you love and watch a movie. There. Happy? Just eat and fuck and love as much as you can for as long as you can. Everything else is just noise. That is, if you want me to send you back down to Earth.
You can send me back?
Yeah, why not? Your injuries weren't awful. We make almost everyone come to this room and we give them that option. It just depends if you want to. Do you? Hey. Hey, dude, I don't mean to rush you, but you have literally 500 million people in line behind you. Just saying.
Yeah, he's definitely dead.
How would you know that?
Oh, I'm a nurse. So are we gonna call an ambulance or the cops or something?
Yeah, it's better the police don't know I was here.
Wait, what? Holy shit, you're alive.
Are you okay?
Oh, and your wallet flew out of your pocket when you got hit.
Is there anyone you'd like us to call?
Don't worry, guys, I'll get this packed up.
Someone want to watch Casablanca?
Yeah.
Okay.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm great.